50 things in Adobe Illustrator that you might not know. Timestamps are in the description. Click using any of the shape tools to bring up a menu where you can more precisely customize the shape you're creating. Do not make triangles using the Star tool. Instead, use the Polygon tool. The reason is that the Star tool will create extra anchor points that are useless. You can turn any path into guides by selecting it, right-clicking and choosing Make Guides from the menu. You can automatically delete stray points, unpainted objects and empty text paths in your artwork by going to the Object menu, then Path, then clicking on the Cleanup option. You can create a second view of your document by going to the Window menu and choosing the New Window option. You can rearrange multiple windows in Illustrator by clicking on the Arrange Documents button on the top right corner and choosing an Arrange option. You can paste text without formatting by using the shortcut Ctrl or Command Alt V. You can hold Ctrl or Command while dragging an object to force snapping on the location where the mouse cursor is. A good amount of tools in Illustrator have menus that allow you to customize how the tool works. Just select the tool and hit Enter. However, not all tools have these menus. You can perform math operations in any numerical input field, such as position or size. If you have a hole in an object, you can select a single anchor point using the Direct Selection tool, then swap to the Selection tool to seize control of the entire path. This way, you can scale and rotate the path. You can select multiple anchor points in your artwork and remove them all at the same time without breaking the path by going to the Object menu, then Path, then Remove Anchor Points. If you double-click on the control point for rounding a corner, you can customize how the corner is beveled. If you hold the Alt key while using the Eyedropper tool, instead of picking up a sample, you'll apply the last sample you picked. If you hold Shift while removing an anchor point using the Delete Anchor Point tool, Illustrator will adjust the handles of the neighboring anchors to maintain the path as close as possible to the original. You can create mirroring designs by going to the Object menu, then Repeat, then clicking on the Mirror option. If you paste a text that is too long for the text box, a red icon will appear in the bottom right corner. If you double-click this icon, Illustrator will create a second text box linked to the first one, meaning that the text will automatically flow between both boxes as you type or delete it. When you finish writing your text, you can hit Ctrl or Command Enter to exit typing mode and select the selection tool. If you select text and other objects such as paths or images, you can activate Text Wrap by going to the Object menu, then Text Wrap, then clicking on Make. If you have objects selected, you can right-click and go to Export Selection to quickly export assets from your document. The selection will also automatically be added to the Asset Export panel. You can let Illustrator simplify a path for you by removing unnecessary anchor points. Select the path, go to the Object menu, then Path, then click on Simplify. You can also right-click with the object selected and choose Simplify there. You can add an extra anchor point between every anchor point that already exists in your path by selecting it, going to the Object menu, then Path, then click on Add Anchor Points. You can move, scale, or rotate a pattern by selecting the Selection tool, the Scale tool, or the Rotate tool, pressing Enter on the keyboard and unchecking the Transform Object option. This way, only the pattern will be affected by the tool. The align functions also work with anchor points, so just select the anchor points you wish to align and use the align panel. If you want to remove an object from a group, instead of ungrouping everything and deselecting the unwanted object, just use the group selection tool to select the object inside the group, hit Ctrl or Command X to cut it, and then Ctrl or Command V to paste it outside of the group. You can easily add an object to a group by copying it or cutting it, selecting one object from inside the group with the group selection tool, and pasting using Paste in Front or Paste in Back. The first four options of the Pathfinder, called Shape Modes, allow you to alt-click them to create a compound shape for working in a non-destructive workflow. This way, you can still edit the shapes individually after the shape mode was applied. You can have a stroke in a group without having it affect every single object. To do that, add the stroke through the Appearance panel and then move it below the Contents layer. You can add multiple strokes to an object by using the Appearance panel. Some effects can be applied either to the entire object or to a specific item in the Appearance panel. In the example, I'm moving the Offset Paths effect from the entire object to a specific stroke. You can generate CSS properties from objects in Illustrator. Just open the CSS Properties panel in the Window menu and select the object you want. Note, the object must be named in the Layers panel. Selecting it with the default name won't generate the CSS. You can also generate SVG tags for HTML in Illustrator. Simply copy any path using Ctrl or Command C, then create a new text object and paste using Ctrl or Command V. If you want to edit an object that is in the middle of other objects, you can double-click on it to isolate the object, making everything else temporarily unselectable. This way, you can select and edit the object however you want without accidentally selecting other objects. You can also do this for a group, so if you want to edit the contents of a group, instead of ungrouping everything, making your changes and then grouping again, just double-click on the group to isolate it from the rest of the document. You can export the same artboards or assets in different file formats at the same time by hitting on the Add Scale button on the Export panel and choosing different file formats. You can also add suffixes and prefixes to the file names of your exports by using these input fields. You can add effects to a group and they will be applied to the group as a whole and not to individual objects. For effects, the group is treated as if it was a single object. You can measure distances in the artboard using the Measure tool and the Info panel. You can quickly access tools and options through the Properties panel. The panel will automatically adjust its content based on the tool or the object you have selected. You can scale strokes, effects, and corners along with the object by checking these options in the General tab of the Preferences menu. You can change the color and scale of the UI in the User Interface tab of the Preferences menu. You can change the angles in which the smart guides will snap while creating objects by checking the Construction Guides option in the Smart Guides tab of the Preferences menu and choosing which angles you'd like the smart guides to snap to. You can recolor your entire artwork in a simple way by using the Recolor Artwork option in the Edit menu under Edit Colors. You can quickly get the closest Pantone match from your CMYK colors in the Recolor Artwork panel by clicking on Advanced Options and then selecting one of the color books in the color library. Have you ever wanted to rotate or scale multiple objects at once while keeping them in the same position? All you have to do is select them, right-click and go to Transform, then Transform Each. In this menu, all transformations will be applied to the objects individually. You can use the shortcut Ctrl or Command D to repeat the last action made, like duplicating, moving or rotating. When using tools like Rotate, Scale or Shear, you can change the anchor point in which the transformation will happen by clicking anywhere in the artboard. You can quickly draw inside of an object, similar to using a clipping mask, by selecting the option Draw Inside in the toolbar. You can quickly lock an object by using the shortcut Ctrl or Command 2. This way, you'll no longer be able to select the object. To unlock everything that's locked, press Ctrl or Command Alt 2. You can paste objects in the same place of the artboard by using the shortcuts Ctrl or Command F and Ctrl or Command B. F pastes in the front and B pastes in the back. And now, this video has ended, and I hope you learned something new. Thank you for watching and have a great day. Bye!